This is Team Uncase. We're back again after a small break, I think a couple of weeks. We've been taking some time off, I guess, or just being lazy. But I think last time we spoke a little bit about this movie that I had watched, but Adi had not. And it's called The Wandering Earth Project.
Goodbye, solar system.
I had already seen it first. I will keep my comments for later. But yeah, what did you think? What was your first impression?
Yeah, I mean, like, when I started it, it looked something that has already been experimented with. There is some problem with the Earth and, you know, a climate change happening and a lot of issues that have come up. And you know, scientists trying to work together a solution as to what has to be done. But unlike the usual scenarios in the movies, wherein like they try to save the Earth by like building ships or spaceships or like sending astronauts to prevent a meteor crashing from into the Earth or preventing all those things, instead this is a wholly different idea that came up, like transporting the Earth itself from the solar system into another solar system, altogether, like basically taking the planet out of the system that it is in and transporting it to another place. So like a very, very different idea that came in like an apocalyptic scenario kind of a movie, but a different idea totally. So that's what is the most interesting point in the whole movie, as to how they are, taking the uprooting the Earth basically and trying to place it in another system altogether, because the sun has basically stopped, generating energy and it has gone dark, and the Earth is basically now in motion, removed from its axis, and now it's in motion in space and it is traveling across its path, crossing paths with different planets. And trying to reach another solar system and trying to survive, basically, which will take approximately 2,500 years of a journey to reach there. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's a very, very different, idea that came in to a very generic idea that has already been experimented with, but the different idea that they came out as a solution is what the interesting point here for this movie is.
Honestly, I think it's the concept that I watched it for. I read about it a little bit and then I was like, okay. Obviously, in terms of how the movie is and how it makes you feel, it's not like Gravity or anything, which were on a different scale altogether, but the concept is just, and you know, reading about it a little bit, it's like, how all these American movies and Indian movies also release in China and then they make it big. So China was like, okay, why not make a movie ourselves here? I mean, we have the money and we have the resources, we have the actors, let's do it. So that's how they started this movie. And they always want to do you one better, right? So meteors, all this is like an old concept. So they're like, okay, let's take the Earth and move it out. So yeah, so the concept revolves around, okay, now the Earth has to go to a separate solar system. So what they do is they put like 10,000 jet engines on the Earth, and then it starts moving out of the solar system. And their idea is they'll go to Jupiter by using these jet engines and then use the Jupiter's gravity to slingshot into the outer, into outer space. And that's where the problems start coming. And, you know, there is a technical issue, of course, which any sci-fi movie has, and you know, it's going to crash into Jupiter, and the whole movie revolves around how they're going to protect it. And obviously there's like group of five or six people, you know, leading the charge and all of that. So like any, it's, I felt like it was in like any other sci-fi movie, except for that the concept was something different that we hadn't seen. You know, like apocalypse and all these things are now getting kind of old. Okay, sometimes the core is not spinning, sometimes the meteors are coming, sometimes the sun has solar. I think the sun and solar flares is like every other sci-fi movie now. It's causing a neutrino reaction. I think 2012 was like the epitome of that genre, and then after that there have been so many movies again, but
I feel like
2012 and Day After Tomorrow on that side.
yeah Yeah, like on the similar lines, like the previous review that we have done for Into the Night, it's the same thing, right? It's a solo player killing people. So that concept is like, you know, over exploited as such. But then, this movie stands out for the idea that it came up with, like transporting the Earth itself out of the, you know, out of the solar system into another system. I would say like they met expectations, like when I started the movie, in terms of graphics and you know, the action sequences and you know, the dialogues that are there. So even though they are generic, it doesn't feel, you know, out of place. And the graphics are like, I wouldn't say it's like Hollywood level stuff, but then
not bad actually.
Yeah, it's like almost world class kind of a thing. Be it the space station designing that they have done, which is pretty realistic, and also they have included Indians on that spaceship as well. So it's not like they have ignored Indian scientists, but yeah. So that designing part.
Yeah, it's you know, the funny thing though is what I felt while watching the movie is whether it's Americans or whether it's Chinese who are making the movie, both of them kind of have the same view of the Chinese manufacturing capacity. Like when the movie started and they were showing like what they had built and how it looked exactly in my head to those mega yachts they make in 2012, like how they go in there and how the Chinese have made all these things. It looked exactly the same, at least to me. I was like, oh, this looks very familiar. So it doesn't matter, it just looks like they have like a fixed set of and they, you know, in all honesty, they might have hired the same graphic designers, who knows. Possibly. But like,
yeah,
which I mean, I guess we should check out, but they just look very familiar and look like, okay, a continuation from that. So I think that kind of made it a little more interesting. And obviously, it being an Asian movie, so to speak, there has to be some emotional drama. Which, you know, if it was made in India, then it would be even higher than this.
Yeah.
But still, there was like emotional drama, this little girl, grandfather, all these things going on.
Yeah.
Which American movie, oh, yeah, you know, grandfather died, okay, fine.
Yeah,
but didn't care much about that.
Yeah, exactly. Like the emotions and the Asian part go hand in hand. Like without emotions, you
like
cannot make
20, in 2012, remember when they ditch their plane and they go and they find this monk and she basically cries in front of his mother saying, yeah, please take my children, please take my children. If that was done in America, they would be like, fuck off.
A very good job done in terms of graphics and the storyline.
It did release in the US before Netflix, but it was always sidelined as, oh yeah, it's another Chinese movie, you know, and only maybe Chinese people went to watch it. But I mean, I guess that's what Netflix is for, right? So that everybody else can watch
exactly.
It.
It's a good watch, and it's not that long as well. It's what 2 hours, 2 hours, 2 hours, 15 minutes or so. And yeah, I mean, like, go ahead and
we can.
Yeah, I mean, like, you can go ahead and enjoy this movie without doubt. There's no questions.
Honestly, I would have preferred it as a TV series, you know, like how the solar flare thing is very stretched, but like Into the Night kind of made it interesting because they went into a series and that kind of made them look at, you know, the deeper things, like the small things, you know, how it's affecting people's mental health and all of those smaller things. So I think if they had, they could have made it into a series. The amount of, apparently they spent $200 million on it.
Good watch. You won't be disappointed with the graphics or the movie's premise and the way it is carried out. Looks authentic, appears authentic, looks authentic, and you know, it's a great experience to watch. And especially, like, I mean, it's in a theater, it would be a different experience, but even at home, you can sit and enjoy this movie as such.
I'm just checking, you know, what we are probably going to do next. But here, I think coming up in this month, I would say we have a pretty good list of movies and TV shows going forward. I think one thing we have spoken about, obviously, is like Overlord or Old Guard. And then I just also finished watching Greyhound. So Adi, when you're ready, I think that's something that we could review. So I think we are also trying to expand in terms of which OTT platforms we're looking at. I recently watched a couple of things on Apple TV and Hulu, which I thought were really interesting. And, you know, obviously I'm watching them in the US. So in India, they might be on a separate platform. But Adi, once he looks it up, he'll be able to kind of tell us, you know, what the next thing would be. So yeah, we are working on coming back with more content. Hopefully we'll be able to at least come back with one every week. Or if we miss a week, then we will do two the next week.
Guys, please do like, share and subscribe the video, as well as share and subscribe our channel as well, both on Instagram and YouTube. We'll be providing a link at the end of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. We'll be coming back soon. Thank you.